Well, here is a grey squirrel eating, of all things, a chip. And here it's actually finishing eating a chip, because I'm talking about basically a potato. And here, look, it comes over to me and I give it a chip. And the reason I found myself feeding a grey squirrel was because I had decided I would buy a burger for lunch and I'd have it in the park because it was quite a nice day. And by accident, I was given some chips with the burger. They confused my order. And I just thought, sure, why not? I'll take some chips, although I didn't need all that much food. And when I got to the park, a squirrel approached me. It actually was trying to steal my food, but I decided I'd give it a chip. And here you can see it eating a chip, and now you can see a magpie is actually harassing it, looking for a chip. Because sometimes if I'm in the park, if I'm eating a sandwich, I will give a little bit to the magpie. And here's the magpie getting a chip and leaving the squirrel alone. Now, this is the grey squirrel, which was introduced to Ireland in the early 20th century. It was given to a lady as a present, believe it or not. I think there were 11 of them or 14 of them or something like that. And they all got loose and spread throughout the country. They're slightly larger than the red squirrel and they're believed to be more dominant. Now, this one, why was she so voracious and so hungry? I'd seen her in the park a few weeks before trying to rob people's lunches as they sat on benches and they wouldn't even realize. And she's totally not shy at all. But you'll notice she's very fat. And the reason she's very fat is, if you see on closer inspection, that she's actually pregnant. You'll notice that you can see the teeth sticking out there under the fur. And you can, actually, as she moved along, the teeth were very prominent. And you can see she's fat because she's actually something inside her. And that something is a baby, or a number of babies, actually. And the reason, if she had already had the baby, she would be taking the chips away with her. But here she's just eating them. She's ravenous. A very cute little animal too. Now, unlike the native red squirrel, these ones do not have ear tufts. Although they have a reddish, a slightly foxy reddish colour, as you can see. Her tail is a little the worse for wear. But that'll thicken out, probably. She was losing some of her fur from molting. But she was remarkably tame. Now, they are, of course, wild animals. And maybe it's not always a good idea if they're not afraid of people, but this is in a city park, in the Herbert Park in Ballsbridge in Dublin. And I kind of like to contribute to the squirrels' population by giving them some food for the next generation.